Well, the most amazing thing to begin with is that this is the studio that at the age 19, I recorded Brave. It is, it's quite, in a really weird way, it's sort of, it's freakishly familiar.
You know, it's taken me right back to one of the most fondest memories of my childhood. When I need you, just close my eyes and I'm with you. And all that I so want to give you, babe, is only a heartbeat away. Yeah, I love it. Let's do another.
Roscoe's amazing. He's like, I am his Dionne Warwick to the Burt Bacharach of our generation. He's quite clearly, he's got everything, all roads have been leading to something like this where he can just apply his complete musical prowess and taste and also his skill at working with other musicians as well.
It's going great. Really, really happy. It's I think there's a whole lot of life and energy that's come into songs that we didn't expect and surprising parts and elements, and yeah, I think it's sounding really great. The band exceeded expectations. Yeah, and the expectations were high because they're all amazing players, but it was really sounded like a band that had been playing together for a long time, which is not that common when you put, you know, four people together who haven't played together much at all before. We both know that I'm not what you need.
I didn't know I was making one of the most important albums of my life here 35 years ago, and here I am now, quite possibly making one of the second most important albums of my life here now, as a response to the world around me through the eyes of my experience, I guess through the distillation of everything I've ever known. Doesn't anybody stay in one place anymore? It would be so fine to see your face at my door. It doesn't help to know you're so far away. It's fun, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah.
It's beautiful, natural.
Yeah. But still, they lead me back to the long winding road. You left me standing here a long, long time ago. Really well-known songs and attempting not to be cliched through them without also doing the other thing, which is worse, which is trying to impose too much originality. I'll never leave, where should I leave? I'd be a fool, cause I finally found someone who really cared. You held my hand. Although the songs are like, you know, they're very famous and they could be seen as being quite indestructible. And yet, in this time, if you put them in the context, they'll make a lot more sense for people, because right now people, they need to be put back together. They've been broken by something. They've been brought undone by something they can't even see. And the only thing that could possibly cure that feeling within them that's broken is familiarity. Hold on. Be strong, your moment. deliver them that feeling without having to be talked into it. It's just going to be simply beautiful, expressive art. High-end bucket list songs. What I needed to do in this record was make all of these songs a favourite album of mine that I'd consider I could sign off after having sat next to Peter Allen at a piano stool and had him sing to me personally this beautiful song. To have had the experience of having his actual physical form next to me in real life, explaining to us, my brother and I, why music was so important to him. And I believe you really ought to know. I love you. I honestly love you. The breadth of my knowledge, all the songs that I've sung and all of the sounds and all of the heroes that have now since passed are sort of residing in me to allow all of that to come out and just give it to people who are no longer listening to any of these artists who I grew up with and who I've loved. These are artists maybe unknown to a lot of the new generation, singer-songwriters who come with them, such a pledge for great songwriting and crafting great songs. And I feel like it's my responsibility to make this the other most important album of my life.